long ago, when we started thinking about CAD/CAM, our dream was to integrate the engineering principles into the kinds of things that dentists do, particularly in terms of making restorations. So we put together a team of people that were basically engineering people along with clinicians and along with material scientists, and created a series of early work and a number of patents that have now become the kind of thing that everyone is doing. The developments have been phenomenal and very, very exciting to be able to change how people think about dentistry and how they deliver dentistry. If I have a little bit of sadness, it's because our system is not one of the ones that made it to the marketplace and being a success. But it's really great fun to see all the work that the teams are doing, to see the kinds of things that are evolving. And it certainly has fulfilled all of the dreams that I had for what was possible. It's really very, very fun. When we started thinking about doing the book on the digital dentistry for confessants, I had three objectives in mind. One of them was that there's so much happening for clinicians and all sorts of new equipment that's being developed that it's hard to keep track of it all, especially if you're not coming from an engineering background or a technical background. So one of the things I wanted to accomplish was to have a comprehensive reference about differences and similarities between different systems so that a clinician could kind of get a sense of what was going on. Importantly, too, it gives them an opportunity to think about what factors they might consider when they're looking for new systems to be able to acquire or new systems that are being developed. So the second objective was to get people to think of digital dentistry as being much greater than just CAD/CAM and intraoral scanners, so that there's a proliferation of different opportunities that can evolve where you can acquire the data, you can manipulate the data, and then you can leverage it to all sorts of new and exciting opportunities that I think people haven't stopped to think about very much. And so one of the objectives was to get some coverage to those kinds of things and in many respects challenge people to think about what else might be useful with the data set that they're acquiring on an everyday basis. And the third one is that my personal belief is that teams are critical for success in the future, particularly in technical areas. So having the teams, being a dentist, an engineer, a genetic scientist, a bioengineer, a material scientist, a scientist that we haven't even thought about yet, I think is really critical for being able to get the best technology the fastest way. So I wanted to have a situation where the book could be a platform for those people who are outside of dentistry to understand what is going on in dentistry and be able to then leverage that into their new ideas and to get a faster track into things that can become a reality for how we think, how we educate, and how we practice. I wanted to capture the richness of the field, the complexity of the field, and integrate different cultures. So we didn't want everything from one area, geographic area. We didn't want everything from one age group of people. We wanted to really get the complexity and richness that does exist in the field. And so we found people that we thought had published substantially and were willing to do the chapter, of course, and asked them to contribute. And we had a great response. And in some cases, the senior clinicians and the senior researchers included some of their young researchers so that they could be more engaged in the process as well. So it was a great experience from my perspective, and I hope that it adds to the value of the book as people read it, to know that it really has looked across different areas of expertise, different geographies, and different cultures. The expectation, the hope for readers of the digital dentistry book is that they will enjoy the exploration. Hopefully it will help demystify some of the frustrations and questions that clinicians might have. But the real bottom line that I would like to achieve with this is for people to enjoy reading it and challenge their imagination for what else might be possible and how we might change in the future with how we think, how we practice, how we educate, and how we treat patients. And I do hope that people find it an enjoyable read.